Welcome back. It's all happening so fast. The mind-blowing speed of the rise of robots. Over the weekend, 500 robots from 16 countries competed at the World Humanoid Robot Games in Beijing. The events featured sprinting, soccer, and boxing matches. Now, some of the robots stumbled, froze, they face-planted, and it's funny to watch. But it's also scary because we know it's happening so fast. We're forced to ask the question, what's next for robots? Here's an idea. Pregnancy? A Chinese tech company is reportedly developing a bot with an artificial womb that could carry a human baby to term. That's one way to use AI and robotics, but what about when it comes to space? Well, we have a unique guest joining us for that discussion. You'll remember him as one of the American astronauts stuck in space for 9 months, and now he has since retired. Joining me now, astronaut Butch Wilmore. Butch, great to have you on the show today. I think it's the first time we've heard from you since you had an incredible sit-down interview with Fox News' Bill Hemmer. You heard my introduction. You had quite an ordeal in space, 9 months, stuck, stranded in space. What do you think about outsourcing those potential problems to robots, to AI for the future of space travel? Yeah.
Hey, it's a very interesting question, Will. Obviously, I'm a big proponent of humans in space. The technical aspect of being there, relaying the information, the experience itself, relaying the experience. I'm not sure a robot could do that. Obviously could do it, but it's not from the same human aspect. Certainly, there's a place for robotics within what we do in human spaceflight and outside of human spaceflight, especially as this AI technology comes online more and more and we learn more better how to use it, there's a great place for that. But I think we still need to send the humans out and do what only humans can do.
It's not hard to imagine something like the movie Interstellar. You have a robotic partner traveling throughout the galaxy with you, the human astronaut. You've been retired, Butch, now for I think just about a month. You're several months home from, again, that 9 months in space. How's life? How are you getting back to normal?
Life is great. It's a great thing to be out and mow your own grass and smell the grass. It's something you long for, some of those just those human type of interactions, hearing the birds sing, all those things. So that's a wonderful aspect, especially when things are different than what had planned right from last year. Last year, things were not going as scheduled. And so there's some things you long for and you miss. Never fret over it because, you know, the good Lord's in control. But certainly to be able to do those things has been great. And there's many irons in the fire now that with retirement, it brings many other opportunities, which, you know, we're exploring. We'll see where the good Lord directs.
Well, Butch, I want to ask you this. You know, now that you're retired, maybe on a chance, you might feel a little more free than you might have some time ago. Though you made a big point when you came home of thanking both Elon Musk and President Donald Trump. It forces me out of my own curiosity to ask you how you felt during those 9 months. Did you feel abandoned in space?
You know, that is a fair question. Abandoned, no. And again, I go back to, like I said, and try to articulate then, there's so many issues, conversations, discussions, questions that are taking place that we just don't have privy to. And when you've got someone like Mr. Musk and our president, Donald Trump, I trust them, like I said. I trust them empirically. They have given me no reason not to trust them. So if they say some things took place that I have no purview over, I have no reason but to trust them. But again, I can't speak directly to those issues because I'm not in those conversations. But from our standpoint, did we feel stranded? No, we didn't feel stranded. Did we feel stuck? There's many definitions of stranded and struck, under which a couple of those, we fit a couple of those definitions, absolutely. But did we feel that way? No, we had a mission. We're focused. We're doing day-to-day routines. We're doing International Space Station, keeping the space station up, doing science every single day, feeling a part of the plan and part of the program, which is important. And we went up prepared, like I've said before as well. We didn't just show up and oh my goodness, what do we do now? We were ready to go forward with whatever contingency. And this is the one that played stuff out.
Well, just to fill in the gaps, you're referencing things that were said by Elon Musk and President Donald Trump about the way your situation was handled by the prior administration. Now, speaking of this administration, though, Butch, I'm about to go meet here in the matter of an hour, acting administrator of NASA, Sean Duffy. And if there is one priority from your perspective to be communicated to him, and you could relay it through me, what would you say to Duffy?
Well, historically, I think over the past several decades, I mean, I've been with NASA 25 years, It's the shifting priorities that have really restricted our progress. One administration has a focus, the next administration comes in and cancels that and goes with another one. I think that's the biggest thing, is these shifting priorities have really delayed our progress in many aspects. And if we could stay focused in a line, even if we tweak the priority we have, that's understandable. But keeping the focus and the priorities in line, I think that's the probably the biggest thing that has impacted us. I don't know if it's negative, but certainly delayed us over the last several decades.
I'll ask for consistency of priorities. I'll identify those priorities and then ask how we can ensure consistency of those priorities. Butch, it's a great conversation. Thank you so much for being with us.
Well, thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
All right. Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.